Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and today we're watching a lip injection, Restylane Define, into a younger person, and I'll explain that in a moment, but firstly, Restylane KYSSE. A lot of people ask me, when is it coming? We were waiting for it, and yes, in Europe, they love it. We don't have it here yet, and despite what people think, I don't have any inside information. It's an FDA thing. But there's two products that will be exciting to come. One is this KYSSE, and the other is what's called Volume or Volume in Europe. It will have a different name here, but it'll be a mid-base filler. I'd be excited for that one, too. They just love it over there. But Define works well, especially for the younger demographic. It doesn't draw water in. You can create shape. You can create the Cupid's bow. You can create the upturn of the lip. You can flip the front of the lip up. There's a recent study showing that the 50-50 lip, so 50% of the volume on top and the bottom, which is different than we know where the top is smaller than the bottom, that conforms to the phi rule, or 1.61 to 1. The 50-50 lip is more accepted. Part of this video is to see what do you guys think below. I learn from you. I learn from everyone I teach and I get taught. But I, the younger demographic, I woke up this morning to a YouTube question, why are you always treating young people? It's what's walking into my clinic. And we have older people, depending on what you think old is, but we have older people coming in and over the age of 50. But the younger demographic, they don't buy cars, they use Uber, they travel, they spend their money on travel, but they also spend their money on their skin and their beauty, and Instagram is in, and their careers and their life and their social life depend on this. They grew up watching their moms and family members get Botox when everyone was worried about it being unsafe, and they're very comfortable with these products. And here she's getting PDO threads above the brow. Preventive maintenance. The brow, she always wants to keep that high brow. And the cost, a lot of people say, hey, how do they get the money? Well, they maintain. And by doing this, she won't have to do a lot of the procedures down the road. Someone 50 and plus who comes in without having had treatments, that's expensive. Lines are etched in. There's been no filler before. We start with collagen stimulators, HA fillers, resurfacing. It can easily add up to $10,000 to $15,000. And estrogen has gone down. So that affects the skin and the facial volume and sag. So sometimes a facelift is best for those people. But it's a different demographic. I'm not angry about it. A lot of people that comment on social media, what are these kids doing? It's a different culture. They accept it, they take care of their skin, and the angles that they create are because their skin is perfect. So they can create folds, they don't need as much product, maintenance is easy, and they're willing to do things like PDO threads to maintain. So I'd love to hear your comments and what do people think about this new generation, what are they doing in their practices?